Hello, cyber citizens. Welcome to AVK classes. Now we know that most of our viewers are curious about everything. Some of us are very curious about astronomical things and desire to know how the universe works. But whether you are a fan of astronomy or not, you may be curious about this thing called as black hole. So we have decided to make a mini-series covering theories about black holes, in our new section called the Black Hole Theory. This is the first episode of the series, so stay tuned to get even more smarter. And don't forget to flex the brain muscles because we are going to get started. The things we know about black holes are that they are very heavy astronomical objects. They have a very high gravitational force, so high that even light can't escape its gravity. But we know that most of the object in universe has mass. And anything that has mass will try to pull less massive objects towards itself, because that's how gravity works. The major difference between a black hole and a normal object is not that it is black in color, but something related to its geometry, called Schwarzschild radius. What is Schwarzschild radius, you may ask? The Schwarzschild radius, sometimes historically referred to as the gravitational radius, is the radius of a sphere such that, if all the mass of an object were to be compressed within that sphere, the escape velocity from the surface of the sphere would equal to the speed of light. That means it becomes a black hole. So black hole is not just a massive object, but it is also a denser. So that means theoretically it is possible to make black hole even in your lab. All you need is this equation. This is the equation of Schwarzschild radius. As you know, Schwarzschild radius is the distance from the center of a black hole to a point below which nothing, not even light, can escape. This is also called as event horizon. And how big it is only depends on the mass of object, since g and c square are constants. So heavier the black hole, bigger the Schwarzschild radius. Now you can use the Schwarzschild radius equation to find Schwarzschild radius of day-to-day objects. For example, you wish to convert an object having mass 100 kilograms to a black hole. All you need to plug in the values and you'll get the Schwarzschild radius. This means you have to compress the object to such a very low radius to turn it into a black hole. That's impossible, you think. It's not. When supergiant starts to die, the supernova explosions are so powerful that they compress the core of the stars past their Schwarzschild radius, turning them into black holes. But now you might not be having supernova strength compression, then you can instead make a black hole by adding more mass to your object. As we know, mass is nothing but product of the density and volume of the object in question. The equation that you will be needing is here. Here we will rearrange the equation so that we will find the radius with respect to mass. Now the radius of the object with a given density is proportional to cube root of its mass. And as stated earlier, Schwarzschild radius of an object is proportional to its mass. So on adding mass, the Schwarzschild radius of an object will increase much faster than its actual radius. Now initially the Schwarzschild radius of an object is very small as compared to its actual radius. But if we keep on adding mass, at some mass the object's actual radius will become Schwarzschild radius, thus becoming a black hole. So you can turn any given object into a black hole, well, at least in theory, just by knowing its density and volume. So by calculations, for Earth, you have to add mass up to a radius of 140 million kilometers before it turns into a black hole. That's it from the first episode of this mini-series. Stay tuned for the next episode. If you liked it, hit the thumbs up button to let us know. If you have any comments, suggestions and ideas for future episodes, please do comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to AVK classes because we make videos every week. And please do press the bell icon to get notified whenever we post a new video. You can also follow us on Twitter and do like our Facebook page. All the links are provided in the description below. Thank you for watching. Hope this video created a spark in your gray cells and helped you to understand the intricacies. We will meet again soon with another video. Till then, stay curious and keep learning. Thank you.